हरिओम, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग फ्रक्टोस, दैट इज फ्रॉम आवर लेसन बायोमोलिक्यूल्स. नो फ्रक्टोस विच इज ऑब्टेन्ड बाय द हाइड्रोलाइसिस ऑफ सुक्रोज. हाइड्रोलाइसिस ऑफ सुक्रोज गिव्स डी प्लस ग्लूकोज एंड डी माइनस फ्रक्टोज. दिस इज C1H22O11 सुक्रोज and hydrolysis gives C6H12O6 C6H12O6. Among them one is D plus glucose and here it is D minus fructose. And you know sucrose is a disaccharide. What do you mean by disaccharide here? Which give 2 units of monosaccharides on hydrolysis. Sucrose will give 2 units of monosaccharides or 2 molecules of monosaccharides or 2 units of monosaccharides on hydrolysis. Here what is one monosaccharide? Here glucose. Another monosaccharide? Fructose. Now we will be discussing about fructose here. Fructose is a ketohexose. What do you mean by keto? Keto means a ketonic group is present. Hexose means hex. 6 carbon atoms are present. And you know, just now I said there is a ketonic function group and it belongs to D series and it is written as a D minus fructose. So what is this minus sign telling us? That it is levorotating. It rotates the plane polarized light towards left hand side or left side. That's why it is levorotating. Levo is a Latin word. Levo means left. And now we will be discussing the structure of fructose. You see here. See the structure of fructose. CH2OH, C double bond O, COH, H, CH, OH, CH, OH, CH2OH. CH2OH, C double bond O, there is a ketonic group at second carbon. This is a ketonic functional group. Ketonic functional group. And CH2OH. There is a homework to you. Find out how many chiral carbons are present in this molecule. How many chiral carbons are present in the structure of fructose? And how many primary alkali groups are there? How many secondary alkali groups are there? That is the homework to you. Please take a screenshot. Now we will be discussing the cyclic structure of fructose. P4-5 hydroxyl group, that is at 5th carbon, and ketonic group at 2nd carbon. See here, oxygen being more electronegative than hydrogen gets minus charge and this will get plus charge. And here oxygen is more electronegative than carbon and it will pull the electrons towards itself. As a result, it will get minus charge, this will get plus charge. There is interaction between this this minus, this attacks C plus, and there is interaction between this O minus and H plus. Finally, what you are getting? You are getting a structure like this. CH2OH. Here, please see here. This H plus go to O minus and this O minus forms a ring with 2nd carbon. Now what you are getting here? C OH. Right, like this. CHOH 1 2 3 4 5. See here, where is the OH group present? Towards your right hand side. So it is what? Alpha D minus fructofuranols. Why it is named as a furanols? I will be saying now. Now suppose if this C double one O is present towards your left hand side. Is present towards your left hand side. Now what will happen? You will get beta D minus fructofuranols. I can show you here. Now you see here, when C double one O present towards your left hand side, you will get beta D minus fructofuranols. If C double one O present towards your right hand side, you will get alpha D minus fructofuranols. There is interaction between the hydroxyl group of fifth carbon, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, oxygen being more electronegative than hydrogen, attains minus charge. This will get plus charge. And here, oxygen being more electronegative than carbon, it will pull the electron towards itself. As a result, it will get plus charge, and it will get minus charge, and it will get plus charge. It will get minus charge, and it will get plus charge here. So this minus attacks plus charge plus deficient carbon. And there is interaction between this H plus and O minus. Finally, what you are getting? You are getting here COH, CH2OH, OH, CHOH, CHOH. CHOH 1, 2, 3, 4. CH2OH. You see, where is this OH group present now? It is present towards your left hand side. Where is the OH group present there? It is present towards your right hand side. So it is beta D minus fructofuranols. Why it is written furanols? Now I will be saying furanols. Please take a screenshot. Hydroxyl group to second carbon, we are getting a 5-membered ring. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are getting a 5-membered ring. And there also we are getting a 5-membered ring. This 5-membered ring structure of fructose is analogous to the structure of furan, which is a cyclic organic compound. Having four carbon atoms, one oxygen atom, as a total this is a 5-membered cyclic organic compound that is called furan. That is called furan. You can see here. One carbon number one, carbon number two, carbon number three, carbon number four, and it is oxygen here. Four carbon atoms, one oxygen atom. It is a this structure is analogous to the structure of furan, which is a cyclic organic compound having four carbon atoms, one oxygen atom. That's why it is called the furanols. Here also furanols, alpha D minus fructo furanols. Now we can write this cyclic hemiketol, cyclic hemiketol or cyclic structures of fructose is correctly represented by Haworth projections. Haworth projections. Please remember here, Fischer projections of fructose is not correctly explaining some of the properties. So Haworth projections are very accurate. That we will learn how to draw this. You need not draw, just learn it. Write like this. You draw a structure like this. Furan. The groups that are present towards your right hand side, right below here, OH, carbon number 1, I am here. Where is CH2? It is carbon number 1, it is carbon number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Carbon number 1, CH2OH, attached to carbon number 2, that is C. Where is the OH group present there? It is present towards your right hand side. So you write below the plane, OH. Now come to carbon number 2, carbon number 3. And it is a carbon number 5. To that it is also carbon number 6 is also attached. Come to carbon number 2. Where is OH group present? It is present your left hand side. If it is present your left hand side, right above H. This is the carbon number 3. Come to carbon number 4. Where the carbon number 4, where is the OH group present? OH group is present towards your right hand side. If it is present to your right hand side, right below. Right below, and it is a H. And now come to the carbon number 5. To that hydrogen is bonded, and there is also CH2OH group. CH2OH group. Always CH2OH group is present above the plane. But when you are writing the structure of furan or beta D minus fructo furanols, you should be very careful here. Carbon number 1, where is this present? It is present towards your right hand side. If it is present towards your right hand side, where you should write? You should write below. You should write below. It is carbon number 1 attached to carbon number 2. Where is this OH group present? OH group present towards your left hand side. If it is present towards your left hand side, right above. Carbon number 1 attached to carbon number, this CH2OH is attached to carbon number 2. This is carbon number 2 here. Second carbon. Now come to third carbon, fourth carbon. To the third carbon, where is the OH group present? OH group is present towards your left hand side. If it is present towards your left hand side, right above. And where is the OH group present at fourth carbon? It is present towards your right hand side, right below. And come to the fifth carbon. To the fifth carbon, hydrogen is attached and there is also hydrogen is bonded. CH2OH group is also bonded to the fifth carbon. And to the fifth carbon, there is also a oxygen. There is also a this fifth carbon, hydrogen, CH2, OH group. This is Haworth productions. These are Haworth productions. Haworth productions of what? Alpha D fructofuranols. Alpha D fructofuranols. This is what? Beta D fructofuranols. These are the Haworth productions. These are the Haworth productions of alpha D fructofuranols, beta D fructofuranols. See, please remember here, the groups that are present towards your right hand side, mainly OH groups here, please. OH group, the group that are present towards your OH groups, if they are projected towards your right hand side, right below, the groups that are projected towards your left hand side, right above, mainly we are confined to OH group one, CH2OH groups here. Okay, these are the Haworth productions here. Now we will be comparing cyclic structure of glucose and cyclic structure of fructose. It is forming a six membered ring. It is forming what? It is forming a five membered ring. Cyclic structure of glucose is analogous to the structure of pyran. Cyclic structure of fructose is analogous to the structure of furan. And you know, alpha D minus fructofuranols, beta D minus fructofuranols, both are anomers because they differ only at the configuration of at second carbon, that is OH present towards your right hand side, OH present towards your left hand side. Such type of configurations are called what? Anomers. They are called anomers. That is about fructose, and also we compare with that of glucose. Glucose is forming a six-membered cyclic structure, six-membered ring, and that six-membered ring is analogous to the structure of pyran. Pyran is a five-membered. It is a six-membered cyclic organic compound having five carbons, one oxygen atom. Total six members. Furan is a five-membered cyclic organic compound having four carbon atoms, one oxygen atom. Total five-membered cyclic organic compound. And you know, alpha D minus fructofuranols, beta D minus fructofuranols, both are anomers because they differ in configuration of second carbon atom.